It's time now for Luke Layston Local News. In the news, the City of Jessup Council having a retreat today and tomorrow at the Cracker Williams Community Center. It gets underway this morning at 9 a.m. On the agenda at 9 a.m., State of the City with City Manager Mike Deal. 9:30, they will discuss the Water Department with Anthony Crawford. 10:15, the Wastewater Department with Patrick Martin. 11 a.m., Public Works with Eddie Williams. 11:30, Downtown Development Authority with Molly Hall. And then their break for lunch from 12 to 1. 1 p.m., Judiciary Complex, discussion with Ed Jefferson, Judge Vi Bennett. 2 p.m., Industrial Development Authority Director Dale Keith will be on hand. 2:30, City Hall with Rose Marcus. 3 p.m., an open discussion with the council, and they'll close today at 4 p.m. Get back in action tomorrow at 9 a.m., Police Department Captains Morgan and Captain Reddish on hand. 10 a.m., Fire Department with Chief Josh Huffman. 11 a.m., Engineer Bill Schumann, break for lunch. Then 1 p.m., Building Inspector Don Heron. 2 to 4 p.m., open discussion with the council, and conclude tomorrow at 4 p.m. Again, the retreat taking place the Cracker Williams Community Center today and tomorrow. Legislative session is in its final week, and we'll be checking in with our local representatives to get their thoughts on what we can expect in the next 3 days. Georgia school librarians are upset by legislation that seeks to remove them from decisions about which books students can or cannot read at school. Currently, the State Board of Education requires that every local Board of Education establish a school district media committee to review parent objections to books, videos, and other materials, but Senate Bill 226 would impose a statewide move with others in charge and clear deadlines and transparency at the end. Typically, school librarians who have graduated with degrees in their field are involved in such decisions, but the legislation would force principals and ultimately school boards to lead the decisions. Bills backed by groups that think parents have little say over the books and websites presented to their children. They say the current process for reviewing books is too burdensome, but having principals or their delegates make the decisions on a tight timeline would streamline the process. Vote is expected to come in the next couple of days as the session again ends on Wednesday. We'll be back with more news after this word from our sponsor of the commercial messages, so please stay tuned. Wayne County Health Department is hosting a drive-through COVID-19 vaccination clinic that's open to all Georgians ages 18 and older. The clinic will administer the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. This will be held on March 31st at the Wayne Memorial Hospital Physical Therapy parking lot, the parking lot close to Highway 84. Address is 865 South 1st Street in Jessup. The hours are 8 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. and 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. Appointments are required. To register, visit the website dph.georgia.gov/COVID/vaccine and select the blue box that states Health Department Scheduling. If you need assistance, you can call 1-855-473-4374. Again, that number 1-855-473-4374. In the clinic being held on March 31st. Again, the times 8 to 11:30 and 1 to 3 p.m. Georgia Governor Brian Kemp says he is planning to loosen the state's remaining coronavirus restrictions, calling it a critical step to return to normal as the number of new infections declines and more Georgians are getting the vaccine to protect against the disease. Governor said Friday that his administration will outline plans to roll back the remaining restrictions, which include capacity limits, restrictions on large-scale gatherings, and dozens of safety guidelines for restaurants, bars, entertainment venues, and other venues. Kemp says Georgians know the right thing to do. They know the value and best practices, but they also can't wait to return to their normal life. Loosening these restrictions is the next critical step in that process, and it signals an even bigger light at the end of the tunnel. The scaled-back changes are expected to take effect this Thursday. We'll be back with some final news notes after this word from our sponsor of the commercial messages, so please stay tuned. Final notes of news, the Jessup Downtown Development Authority is getting ready for their downtown shop, hop, and egg hunt Thursday, April 1st. 20 golden eggs will be hidden in downtown businesses. Eggs will be redeemable for a $50 gift certificate when it's found in that business. Again, it all takes place this Thursday, April 1st in downtown Jessup. Also, the Altima River Run has been scheduled for April 17th, 8:30 a.m. at Upper County Landing. Time to enjoy the beauty of the Altima River at the Wayne County Board of Tourism's Altima River Run, set for Saturday, April 17th. This year's paddle will begin at 8:30 a.m. at the Upper County Landing. Paddlers will have the choice of two takeout points. 11-mile paddle will take out at Pig Farm Oglethorpe Landing. 16-mile paddle will take out at JC Landing. Registration $10 per paddler prior to the event, $15 on the day of the event. Children 10 and under paddle for free with a registered adult. Altima River Expeditions has canoe, kayak, rental for $45 each. Contact them at 912-294-3604. Shuttles will be available from the takeout points with the shuttle leaving JC Landing at 8 a.m., Oglethorpe Landing at 8:15 a.m. Registration forms are available at the Jessup Train Depot or online at the Tourism Board website, WayneTourism.com. Online registration is available at imathlete.com, which can be accessed through the Tourism Board website as well. Bring your hat, sunscreen, and snack lunch. Enjoy the spring beauty of the Altima River. Again, the date, Saturday, April the 17th. That's going to do it for the latest in local news. Sports comes your way in a few minutes. Bob Morgan, send have a great day.